Get ready to jump, jive, and swing at the Broadway Palm Theater. Tony-nominated musical Swing is now playing at the Broadway Palm and sweeping audiences away.
This morning, we have Sammy Doherty and we have Jelani Bell with us, getting us more on this awesome musical, celebrating music, dance, big exclamation mark, we're talking. And it's Swing. I think Big Band Swing is my jam. I love it to death.
Guys, that's what the show is all about.
I'm all for it. Sammy, tell us a little bit about the show and what it is.
So the show tells the story of a community of dancers and of just normal people who kind of come together in a club setting or a lounge type setting. And it's not told through conventional dialogue, but through acting, through lyrics, and through dance. You get to learn a little bit about these different couples and what their life is like as they make their way through the war times, awesome. World War II. And become a tight-knit community that shares in the love and joy of swing dancing.
Cool.
So it's the big band type era and music. And
absolutely.
Well, some favorites I would assume that everyone knows and loves.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Swing It, Brother Swing.
Oh, okay, yes.
That's right.
And Jelani, you came down here from Virginia. How does it feel to be in Fort Myers on the stage here and dancing your heart out?
Well, it feels great. It's not my first time in Fort Myers,
actually.
Yeah, I've worked with the Broadway Palm before.
Nice.
So happy to be back, I would say. Yeah, very comfortable, very nice.
It's a very fun venue.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's great.
Well, it's a very fun venue. So are there, like, certain characters involved in the show, or is it mostly just kind of performance-based?
There are four main singers who kind of have the most defined characters, and their lyrics definitely lend to the plot line, but our director-choreographer, Miss Amy McCleary, did an incredible job of also structuring these other couples that you see throughout the show that we kind of refer to without names, but with kind of defining characters like Jelani and Amy Fennecle are part of the love couple and dancers in love. And myself and my partner, Riley, we do a comedic routine. So we're called the comedic couple, and we do kitchen mechanics and have a fun dance in the second act where we transform into elegant members of the Savoy Club.
That's cool.
It sounds like a lot of fun. Is it exhausting? I would think it would be a challenge to put it on every night.
It's a little bit like cardio conditioning.
It takes some stamina.
I'm sure. Yeah, because you're moving throughout the whole thing.
Yes.
How many shows are you doing a week?
Right now, we're only doing 7 a week.
Only 7.
Only.
They're doing more than us.
Yeah.
In peak season, we do 9 shows a week.
That's incredible.
Right now, yeah, we have
shows
playing Wednesday through Sunday, evening shows every night, a twilight show on Sundays, and then we have at least one weekday and weekend matinee.
Do you get into some kind of routine with the shows at least? I mean, you know, with the demanding schedule that it is.
Oh, yeah, we're already starting to, like, settle into it, and the conditioning and everything helps.
So.
It sounds cool.
Yeah, it's a labor of love, though. We all absolutely love what we do. And there's also something cathartic about getting out there and just, like, dancing yourself silly for a while.
Well, it's
a
difficult style of dance, too.
Yeah.
Swing dancing.
Oh, yeah, and we're all running on endorphins, which, you know, our director really emphasized the fact that that's what's so special about swing dancing is that it was created for people to connect and come together. And it definitely... helped strengthen a community during a very tough time.
Yeah, absolutely.
And we're finding the joy in that as well.
So where does the play take place? Or is it just kind of like a no-name place?
Yeah, it takes place mainly in a club.
Yeah,
okay.
But I understand you guys are brave enough to teach us something, or try to, should be the honorable word.
I just want to say that I did do a dancing competition.
Yes, you did.
Hey,
you're still mad.
I chose a swing number, got perfect tens from all judges.
Oh, how exciting.
And I still didn't win.
He didn't win. He's still bitter.
I am bitter about
this. It's a whole thing.
I haven't danced since.
Well, you're winning today. So we were going to teach you guys just how to do a basic Lindy.
Okay.
Cool. So the females start with their right foot behind, and the gentlemen start with their left foot behind. But you face your partner with both hands.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're going to start by just doing a basic rock step away from each other.
Step
back on your left.
Well, you'd go back.
And I'm stepping back on my right.
Oh, so okay.
Rock step. And then we do what's called a triple
step.
Bringing that foot through. Triple step to switch.
Okay.
And now you do the other foot.
Oh, you're turning it.
Rock step.
Triple like the kids step.
Have you been doing swing classes or
swing dancing your whole life, or different types of dancing, or
I started dancing in college. college, actually. Oh, that's awesome. Yeah, so when I was 18, that's when I took my first dance class.
Oh, cool.
Most of us did the tap thing and the jazz thing and the, you know.
Jen's a big fan of the old box stuff.
Musical theater?
That's a great one.
We've got a few of those in the show.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, that's a classic.
All right. So it's got to be kind of a switch, though, to stick just to swing versus the other styles that are in there.
Yeah, it's definitely different from what we normally do. Yeah. You know, we're all professional musical theater performers, so like trained in ballet, tap, jazz, and musical theater. Mm-hmm. So it's different for us. And our director was very encouraging to remind us that it's a free form style of dance about joy.
Right. Oh, that's good.
Because of course we're all very technically driven, and so we
each step has to be where it is.
Yeah, we had to learn to cut loose and really like just let the music guide us and trust our partner to work together. And it's different, but it's a lot of fun.
Was it tough to learn all the dances, all the steps? I feel like there would have to be some rehearsal process.
Yeah, was it?
A little. There was difficulty, but I think we all came together and learned it, like, really well.
Yeah.
We all just really supported each other through it. So.
We're getting great reviews, and it sounds like, I'm sure, are the audiences, they have to be loving it, I would assume.
Yeah,
I think so.
They seem to be very responsive.
Yeah.
So we love to hear and see that they are really like getting invested in the storyline. Mm-hmm. And a lot of them, I think it's very reminiscent of their childhood yesteryear and the style of music. So it's really rewarding to see when they are enjoying themselves and emotionally moved.
The music itself is a very positive sound, too.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
It's just a really great sound of music. Good pieces of music.
Yeah, and we've got a great variety in the show.
Yeah, I love it.
I know that the ticket's available. How can we get those? Contact the box office, I would assume?
Yeah, you can call Broadway Palm, or you can go to the website through broadwaypalm.com, and tickets are available. The show is going to be running for a few more weeks.
Okay.
We close on June 22nd.
All right.
So come on out and swing out with us.
All right.
We love it, man.
Well, thank you so much for coming in. And
we
always love the shows at the Broadway Palm. You guys are so talented.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
And you'll love those shows, too. So go check it out. Swing is playing at the Broadway Palm, as I mentioned. You have time to get those tickets. There are tickets available, and it's great. You get the whole experience. You have your dinner and a great show and a great time. And we'll put information about how to get in touch with the Broadway Palm on our website, too, which is abc-7.com.
Greg's dancing this music.